What is going on, YouTube? We are back at it again. Game number 5 of week number 9, and it's going to be a fun ride here in the Eastern Conference. New Jersey finding life, and they're trying to stay pace in the East, while Pittsburgh, they're trying to hold on to dear life for the number 2 seed. So should be a fun ride between these two teams. We're kind of speed through them all. We got one more game to do after this one, so make sure you don't go anywhere. We're gonna keep the games rolling. Can't wait to see how it goes down. You already know how we do. Best of luck once again to both of these teams, and without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the gameplay. Best of luck to both of these teams, and I'll be back midway through, or if I see anything crazy, I'll go ahead and pop it on for you. So best of luck to Pittsburgh and New Jersey, as it looks like they take it down to the 25-yard line. Pittsburgh starting us off.
Thank you. I can't believe they let you play. Thank you. check. kicker on for the extra point.
Check, check, 59. Go, 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 go. You 52! Rock 52!
Looks like we got the game wrapped up. I'm just going to go ahead and go through the statistics, but great job from New Jersey getting the job done. Holding on to the three-point lead, winning 27-24, a great game overall. I kind of missed a little bit of it like halfway through, but I got to the end. But a great job nonetheless. They got the field goal needed, took the lead, and great job nonetheless all the way through. As we go through these stats real quick. 35-47 there for Desire Augustus, two TDs, and both quarterbacks posting more than 70% completion percentage. You see right there, 79 there for the long pass from Money Mills, 40 for Desire, and Money Mills only missed two passes all game long, 16 for 18. On the other side for rushing, we got 12 for 81, one touchdown there for Spiderweb. Mike Hawk was 11 for 55 doing his thing. Desire Augustus, 3 for 1. Levante Lewis 2 for 7, Guy Clausen 1 for negative 5, Ryan Bandy 1 for 7, Money Mills 1 for negative 1, and there was a fumble there from Augustus earlier in the game. Longest carry of the day was Spiderweb with 18. Let me just make sure you got that there. Make sure you got that. Receiving wise, Darren Wadion led the way in catches, yards, and got a touchdown as well. 12 for 137, 1 TD. Zachariah Branch, 6 for 100, doing his thing. Drew Stowe, 5 for 52. Ryan Bandy, 5 for 31 and a touchdown. Spiderweb, 4 for 3. Antonio Lewis, 3 for 58. And longest carry was 40. One of his longest catch was 40 there from Antonio Lewis, doing his thing. On the other side, we got Guy Clausen and Ty White leading the catches, 4 for 34. And 4 for 24 and a TD there for Ty White. Great job. Mike Hawk, 3 for 88. One touchdown. Blake Grant, 2 for 20. Anthony Stank, 2 for 82. One touchdown. Ronnie Shanahan, 1 for 11. One touchdown. Actually, no touchdown. That's right at the catch. But the longest catch was by Anthony Stank. That Moss from earlier. And Mike Hawk actually had a long touchdown catch as well. So great job there for them. Defensively, Mother Dunn led the way in tackles with 12. Austin Wheel with 11. Andrew Fugle with 8. Big House with 6. Jerry Philbin, Wetzel, and Lester with 4. Darnell Pope with 2. CJ Bird with 2. Jackson Brady with 1. Tank Jones with 1. Makani Kokoa with 1. And Seth Welch also with 1. Wheeler and Fugle had a tackle for loss apiece. Let's see. Mother Dunn and Austin Wheeler had a sack. Great job. No INTs here. Pass deflections. Wheeler, Bird, Lester, and Fugle each had 1. Mother Dunn forced a fumble. Seth Welch recovered it for 3 yards, and that's all the defensive stats there. On the other side, the leading tackler will be David Sutherland with 7, A.B. Johnson with 4, Jet Sosa with 4, Tiger Band with 3, LaDavis Button with 3, Ethan McWells with 3, J.C. Judon with 3, Kashawn Williams with 3, Antonio Lewis there with 2, JaVale Woods with 2, Matt Phillips with 1, Essence with 1, Perrin Ibarra with 1, Rich Chatterson with 1, Levante Lewis and Barber Burr each getting a tackle. LaDavis Button, David Sutherland and Jet Sosa each had a tackle for loss. Sutherland had a great game himself with 2 sacks. Great job. No INTs, no pass deflections needed, nor fumbles or anything like that. And that's all the defensive stats there. Kicking wise, perfect on both sides. Eddie Sato's 2 for 2. On field goals, Anita was 1 for 1. They were both 3 for 3 on extra points, so definitely could have helped the side of the game if either of those kicks were missed. So great job from them. Make sure they did what they need to do. Eddie Sato had 1 punt for 47 yards. Anita was 3 for 138, or should I say Anita Dickamy had 3 for 138. Great job from her. Zachariah Branch led the way in return average there with 26. But Guy Clausen had the yards there, 6 for 135. Punt return wise, Levante Lewis and Mike Hawk each had a punt return for less than 10 yards. And it looks like Levante Lewis won that battle. But let me just go over the summary real quick. See, had the catch there by Pittsburgh, the only touchdown pass. When that happened, it was, let me see, this is third quarter, so it had the touchdown. It looks like Pittsburgh led the way for a little bit, then New York just started chipping away, and you see right there, 17-7 in the second half, definitely settled the ball game. So shout out to everybody in the chat. We got one more game left to do, and it's going to be this one here on the screen. It's going to be St. Louis and Huntington Beach going at it. Let's go ahead and get into it. I'll talk to you all later. Stay safe, everybody. We'll get this one rolling.